they're going from emotional eating to fear of gaining too much weight.
Putting on the pandemic pounds, it's the reality for so many. Some even calling the weight gain during quarantine the COVID-15. At first I was doing really good, but as the pandemic kept going, I think then it was just easier to start eating again.
At some point, it just becomes overwhelming.
And it does,
For stress eaters like us, that's the response. Mm-hmm. But we're getting you more tonight because we found out thousands of people using intermittent fasting as a way to deal with the COVID-15 are actually doing it wrong.
Yeah, ABC 7's Megan Miller is getting us more on why a new study has some serious concerns about that trendy diet.
These days, it's not just fashion looks or social media hashtags trending, it's diets too.
Keto, low carb.
A couple years ago, I did the Body for Life diet.
The diets right now that I hear the most people talk about are keto, intermittent fasting, and paleo.
For now, let's focus on one, intermittent fasting.
I have heard of it. My husband tried it.
I've tried it, but only for a couple of days.
There are different methods.
The most common kind or most common type that we see is what we call time-restricted feeding.
The idea is to fast for 14 to 16 hours, sometime during the day.
People might stop eating at 8 p.m. and resume eating at 12 noon the next day.
Dr. Brian Tashner, a cardiologist at Millennium Physician Group, is just one of many doctors questioning the impacts.
Most experts feel that that's not necessary to go for that long. And in fact, they feel that there could be some harm in that our bodies really like to have fuel in the morning.
In a recent study presented to the American Heart Association, doctors followed 41 overweight adults. Everyone involved ate the same healthy pre-prepared meals for 12 weeks, but half of them only ate during specific hours of the day.
And what they found in this study was that it really didn't have a major effect.
People in both groups lost weight and had decreased blood pressure, regardless of when they ate. But some say they do notice results from fasting. And if you don't, you could be doing it wrong.
A lot of people that do this have this backwards.
Dr. Tashner says instead of skipping breakfast, try dinner, because then
you're really front-loading your calories, you're fueling your body in the morning, and you're not eating at night when these calories tend to have a more dangerous effect.
With these diets becoming more popular in new ways, we also wanted to find out how a strict diet could affect your mental health.
Anything that's obsessive is not balanced.
Dr. Laura Streffler says we should focus on the why.
Are you just looking to lose a little bit of weight because your jeans got too tight during COVID? Or are you thinking that you're not lovable or attractive or worthy at the weight that you are? And that's when we really have clinical concerns and it can be a problem.
Now, it is important to note the study we looked at was small and focused on a specific population of mostly black women with diabetes or pre-diabetes. Dr. Tashner says other studies have shown big benefits, but overall, this type of fasting does need more research. I'm live in the studio tonight, Megan Miller, ABC 7.
Let's get you more, because that's what we do here on ABC 7. Some ways you can lose the pounds outside of dieting: manage your stress, practice mindfulness and basic self-care like taking a hot bath or exercise, maybe yoga. Also, make sure you're sleeping well too. Too little sleep or too much sleep can lead to weight gain. So try to stay on a relatively normal sleep schedule and move more. If you're working from home, you're burning far fewer calories than pre-quarantine. Experts say you should commit to a certain amount of exercise to earn your TV or community time. Now-